My eyes yell, they speak a story, a world, a reality. For you are a foreigner to this world it sees. It wants to cry, to bring the tears of love and passion down. Its beloved has kept her waiting, while her beloved has been kept by the world in a waiting. Waiting, waiting, waiting. The clock ticks and the second pass by. World War I, World War II, Japan bomb, 15th of Hordad Revolution evolved. The Soviet Union falls, Israel bombs, Lebanon free, the two World Trade Center falls. Afghanistan, Iraq invaded, Saddam executed, Bush hated, Palestine invaded, economies devastated. WikiLeaks leaks the data. The world pandemic hits us hard, and the Black Lives Matter movement shakes America up. Do you not see, or must I go on? Signs, 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 one after another. Yes, the ultimate revolution has begun. The idols of patriotism and capitalism are being shattered. Humanity is losing all hopes in the idols it's made in. One by one, these idols are being knocked out and will keep continue falling, inshallah. So there remains no idols to worship. Yes. This is La ilaha illallah. For you to believe in Allah, you must deny all gods in all shapes, forms, and size. Yes, this is the second era of ignorance, where the culture needs to be changed, and slavery, to less power and fame, must be diminished. Humanity needs to be awakened from its deep slumber, from the brainwashed of media, to the starving children of Somalia. All oppressed people must be freed, once and for all. Yes, it's the story of Yusuf, 7 years of prosperity and 7 years of disparity, when then the other side of the world, the Muslim world, Muslims are showing their true faces, hypocrites are being differentiated, haq and batil are showing. And now, the Muslim Ummah is finally awakening. It's realizing how much it's in need of its Yusuf, Yusuf of Fatima the Zahra, not only of its Yusuf, but their 313 as well. For a mission of such greatness needs a strong army of believers. O believers, wake up. It is time for you to realize, to change a world, you must change the world inside. For I knew a man who was told this can't be done. He did so and broke the darkness of this very night. So as we wait for the sunrise to start, the second, this moment, this very breath you take, start on the path that the Quran states. The path of Ibrahim. Ittaba millata Ibrahima Hanifa. To walk in his shoes and follow his steps. In his time, people were worshipping the sun, the moon, the stars, idols of all sorts. So you need to identify the idols of your time and make sure you aren't worshipping them in blind. We mustn't live for our children or family, or even to fulfill our pockets with money. For most people, it's been stated, ittakhasu ilahun hawa, that most people have taken their desires as their lord. But as the Quran states, قُلْ إِنَّ السَّلَاتِ وَالنُّسُكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, that our salat, our prayers, life and death should be for Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. So polish your intention, for that is the first step. Take a step towards Him and He will help you back, strengthening you in your steps. Another note from a wise man, be the change you want to see in the world. Then don't let the wind blow on you. Blow the wind onto the world. And always remember that maybe, just maybe, tomorrow, He will come.